this whole world, this whole universe, we see that it is there. But the physical laws of nature doesn't guarantee that the universe had to be there, right?
Yeah.
It could not have been. So what do you think about that?
We are very lucky to be here. That's what I think. Because the Big Bang, as we know, is a miracle. It happens around like in a millennia. So it happened and it's lucky. And furthermore, that we exist on this planet is a miracle in itself. Because the chances and the probability of us being here has been very low. So the evolution, we need to thank to the evolution.
Okay. So when I look at it, like you said, Big Bang, okay, like general relativity theory. So it says that time, space and matter, it all began at one point. That's the singularity that we call in technical term. Okay. So before that singularity, there was nothing. Like scientifically, we can say that time, space and matter, all three started at one point, and that single point is known as Big Bang.
Yeah.
And because time, space and matter began at that time, so there was nothing before that.
Yeah.
Not even space, no time, no matter, nothing.
Yeah.
Okay, no dark energy, nothing like that. Okay, so in that sense, but still the universe came into existence.
Yeah.
What caused the universe to came into existence?
I think there must be other Big Bangs as well. Like there was ours that created our universe. I don't know if you have heard about the string theory. The string theory suggests that there are multi universes. So basically I think there might have been multiple Big Bangs around that time.
Okay. So, okay. I've heard about, this is irritating. Okay. I've heard about it. Like you said, string theory. Okay. The multiverse theory. See, the multiverse theory, even if you go by the multiverse theory, and first thing is it has now not been proven. It's just a hypothesis
proven.
Okay. So, and even with that, see, string theory or M theory, it suggests that it's the world, the universe or the reality should have 11 dimensions, right?
Yes,
so, but the string theory itself doesn't suggest why it should have that particular dimension.
Yeah, but because it's just a hypothesis.
Yeah.
So I believe that there might have been multiverses. There are multiverses, because beyond a point, what is there? Do you see there's an end to this universe? If there is, there might be another universes out there.
Okay, so there are some theories that were suggested. So, one is oscillating theory. Have you heard about that?
I think.
Oscillating. And okay, so you know about the second law of thermodynamics?
No.
Entropy.
Entropy. Can you give me some insights?
Okay. There are three laws of thermodynamics. The first one is energy cannot be created, it cannot be destroyed.
Destroyed,
okay?
Yeah. Quantum physics, it's a
yes.
law of quantum physics.
Yes, and the second one is that with time, entropy increases. That means with time, as the time increases, the disorder increases.
Okay. Yeah.
Okay. The disorder increases.
Okay.
So with that, and there's one theory proposed by BGV theorem. It's called Bode, Guth and Willenken.
Okay.
Those three scientists, what they found out with, and what they said is, given the entropy, given the thermodynamics, the world and the expansion rate of the universe, the world had to have a beginning, and we can, and there was nothing, absolutely nothing beyond that singularity.
Yeah,
okay,
yeah.
And in this physical universe, that we even if you go by the multiverse theory,
okay,
the multiverse itself had to be, someone had to cause the multiverse,
yeah,
right?
So, yeah,
yeah, right.
There's
one universe, there are 100 universes, there are 1,000 universes,
yeah.
But how, I'm talking about the origin of that,
yeah.
Something had to cause it,
yeah,
right? Maybe in other multiverses, the physical laws are different, maybe,
yeah.
Maybe people are like upside down,
yes.
Everything is upside down, but still, what caused that?
Okay, I'm into some sci-fi movies, so I love Interstellar. So, according to Interstellar, they say that he goes into the dark hole, right? You have seen it.
I've heard it.
Yeah, so basically what he does is, he pushes himself off into a black hole. So, when he reaches the bottom or the middle section of the black hole, he finds that he is in a time loop, a certain time, a kind of time loop. So in that time loop, what happens is, he gets an idea about there, his idea is that what he proposes is that the people like ours have created that time capsule for him. So it might be that our ancestors might be at some level right now,
okay,
that they might have created something huge for us.
Okay.
So that might be the case.
Okay, that's a sci-fi movie.
Yeah. That's
yeah. True. So what I'm thinking is,
yeah.
Okay, let's say. So like I said, there's no physical reality that suggests that universe had to exist,
okay.
But it came into existence.
Yeah.
Okay. Now suppose. Now I'm thinking of a cause. What might have caused it?
I think maybe. Because some particles, like the smallest individual particle, I don't remember the name, what it's called, beyond the electron spectrum, it is quarks.
Quarks,
yeah. So the quarks, they came together and they formed some kind of bombs. It must have been some kind of chemical reaction.
Okay, again, let me go back to singularity, okay, the Big Bang, okay?
Yeah.
Time, space and matter began there, okay?
Yeah, yeah.
The quarks you are saying began there.
Yeah.
Before that, there were no quarks, nothing, okay? And the universe, it cannot itself cause it, okay? Now, but still, it began 13.8 billion years ago. Why not 1,000 million years ago? Why not 100 days ago?
It might have existed. We never know. It might have been destroyed because of something.
Uh-huh.
And precursor to that, something might have happened. So that may be the case that that was the beginning of our universe as well.
Okay, the current exploration in this field of cosmology, what it suggests is the law of thermodynamics.
Okay.
It eliminates all of those things. Law of thermodynamics eliminates every second law of thermodynamics, entropy eliminates all those things, and it pushes us to a point where we have to accept that it has some. Even if you go further back, billion years ago, years ago we go to, we have to have a beginning. That's what it suggests.
So that's the point of curiosity for everybody,
yeah.
I guess.
So second law of thermodynamics. So we have all those theories, but we have to also keep in mind the facts.
Yeah,
what we have.
Exactly.
Right?
We need to keep an open mind regarding everything.
Yeah. Another thing is that whatever begins to exist must have a cause. In the physical world, anything we see, it all depends. Everything is dependent. Right? This microphone that I'm holding is dependent.
Yeah.
It could not have been, but it came into existence. It cannot sustain itself, it can be destroyed. So it cannot sustain itself. Likewise, the universe cannot sustain itself.
Something
it will,
has to be.
Yeah, something has to be there. It will someday, it will go vanish, right?
I think the answer lies in quantum physics. We need to explore more quantum physics because the answer is in the bits.
Mm-hmm.
As we go dig deeper, as we go explore the microscopic levels, we will get the answers, I think.